Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Hair Loss Show. In today's episode, we're going to tackle a question that I get asked all the time during consultation is, how long do I need to be on finasteride? So stick around and we'll answer that question shortly.
Welcome to the Hair Loss Show. Dr. Russell Knudsen and Dr. Vikram Jayaprakash discuss issues relating to hair loss and the medical and surgical treatment of hair loss in both men and women.
Hi everyone, welcome back to the Hair Loss Show. Thanks again for watching. If you like this channel, please remember to like and subscribe, and that helps us get the content out to more people. So this is a question, how long should I be on finasteride? I get asked this question all the time. Both Russell and I get asked this question. And, you know, the answer is always the same, and it's, you know, I don't want to be oversimplistic about it, but the answer is, you should take it as long as you want to keep your hair. And that's effectively the sum and substance of that that answer. What you're trying to do with finasteride, so remember, finasteride, what it does, male pattern hair loss is caused, there's a genetic component of it, but it's caused by the conversion of testosterone into another form of that testosterone called dihydrotestosterone. And there's an enzyme called the 5-alpha reductase enzyme that does that. And what finasteride does is it blocks that enzyme and therefore lowers that level of DHT. With finasteride or any blocker therapy or deuterostride as well, what we're trying to do is to stop the progression of hair loss. What we're trying to do is to stabilize the hair loss. It is not going to grow you new hair. You can't go from bald to having a full head of hair. So we're trying to stabilize this. So we're trying to minimize the amount of DHT that's causing that miniaturization and keeping that at bay for as long as possible, or certainly until your gene for hair loss turns off. So the reality is you can be on that for as long as you need to. Now there's no prescriptive amount of time because each individual is genetically predetermined to turn on their gene for hair loss at a particular age and turn off their gene for hair loss at a particular age. And there's no way of telling, you know, what your age of turning it on or off actually is going to be. So you can be on the dose long term, provided you're not suffering from any side effects of that, with the view that it's going to stabilize the condition. And then at some point, in conjunction with your prescribing physician, you may talk about, well, look, maybe I can come off the finasteride and see how things are progressing. And certainly we've had patients that have been on it for many, many years and have stabilized their hair loss. So there's no issue about taking it long term. That's perfectly fine. But you want to take it as long as you want to keep your hair. I don't mean to be oversimplistic about it, but that's in essence where the answer lies, is that you need to be on finasteride for as long as you want to keep your hair. All right. So hopefully that answers that question with a degree of clarity. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again on the next episode. Take care.